Hello and welcome to the Theory of Computation lectures. So far we have solved different types of problems on NFA. In this class, we'll also solve a problem on NFA, but we'll do something slightly different. We'll solve a problem using NFA and we'll solve the same problem on a DFA. And we'll see which one is easier. Okay, so let's start and we'll design a NFA over input alphabet 01 to accept strings ending with either 0110 or 010. So basically, our language will contain all sorts of strings which end with either 0110 as in this case or a 010 as in this case. So let's start by designing a NFA for this language. So we begin with an initial state A. On A, if we receive a 0 or a 1, we remain there. But then, if we receive a 0, we go to B. If we receive a 1, we go to C. If we receive a 1 at C, we go to D. And if we receive a 0 at D, we go to a final state E. So this is the NFA which accepts strings ending with 0, 1, 1, 0. Now, let's also add the capability to accept 0, 1, 0 to this NFA. Now, from initial state, if we receive 0, 1, we go to state C. If we receive 1 in state C, we go to state D. So if we receive 0 in state C, let us take it to another final state F. So if the NFA receives 0, 1, 0, it goes to another final state F. So this is basically the design of a NFA which accepts strings ending with 0, 1, 1, 0 or 0, 1, 0. Now let's design a DFA to accept the same language. That means we will design a DFA now to accept strings ending with 0110 or 010 over the same input alphabet 0 and 1. So once again, the language will contain all sorts of strings ending with either 0110 or 010. So now let's start to design the DFA which accepts this language. So as usual, we start with an initial state A. On A, if we receive 0, we go to B. On B, if we receive 1, we go to C. On C, if we receive 1, we go to D. And on D, if we receive 0, we go to the final state E. This is a DFA which will accept a string ending with 0110. And if we want to add the capability of accepting 010 on state C, if we receive 0, we will take it to another final state, which is F. So up to this is fine. Now remember, in the case of design of DFAs, we have to complete the machine. For example, we have said what will happen if we receive a 0 in state A, but we have not said what will happen if we receive a 1 on state A. Now notice this string, if we receive a 1 on state A and then receive 010, we can still accept the string, right? So we can actually remain in a loop in state A. So we will keep in state A as long as we get a 1, and then if we receive a 0, 1 and 0, then we can take the machine to a final state. That means that string can be accepted. Now what will happen if we receive a 0 in state B? This is an example here. For example, initially the machine was in initial state A, then we received a 0 to go to final state B. So when we are here, we have received a input 0. Now in state B, if we receive another 0 and then we receive 1, 1, 0, then we can still go to the final state, right? So in state B, if we receive a 0 followed by a 110, we can still go to the final state. So we are going to remain in state B as long as we get zeros. That means there is a loop on state B or zeros. State C is already complete. We have given two transitions, one for input 0, another for input 1. So let's complete state D. And let's think what will happen if we receive a 1 in state D. So we are in state D means we have so far received input 0, 1, 1. Now if we receive another 1, the only way to now complete the pattern, that means end a string with either 0, 1, 1, 0 or 0, 1, 0, is to take the machine to a state from which if we receive either 0, 1, 1, 0 or 0, 1, 0, we can still complete our pattern. So on D, let's take the machine to state A for input 1, so that after this, if we receive 0, 1, 1, 0 or 0, 1, 0, we can still complete our pattern. Okay. Now let's think what will happen if we receive a 0 in state E. Now we are in state E, that means we have already received 0, 1, 1, 0. In this case, look at this example where we have received 0, 1, 1, 0 so far. So at this stage, we are in state E. Now if we receive another 0, we can receive a 1 and a 0 to go to the final state again. So on state E, if we receive a 0, let's take the machine to state B. So that if we receive a 1 and a 0 after that, we can still come to the final state. Now on state E, what will happen if we get a 1? Once again, we are in state E means we are already having 0, 1, 1, 0. So now if we receive a 1, we can still get a 0 and go to the final state. So on state E, if we get a 1, let's take the machine to state C. So that means we have received 0, 1, 1, 0 and a 1 to go to state C. At this stage, if we receive a 0, we can still go to the final state F, as we can see in this example. Now let's look at state F and think what will happen if we receive a 1 in state F. So we are in state F means we have already received 0, 1, 0. If we receive a 1 after that, then we can still receive another 0 and complete the string which ends with 0, 1, 0. So on state F, if we receive a 1, let's take the machine to state C. So that if we receive a 0 after that, we can still complete our pattern. Okay. And now let's think what will happen if we receive a 0 in state F. So once again, we are in state F means we are having a string which has so far received 0, 1, 0, as in this case. Now if we receive a 0 after that, we can get a 1 and a 0 to complete the pattern and go to the final state F. Now what is the state in which we have a 1 and 0 after that and we can still go to the final state? That state is state B. So on state F, if we receive a 0, we can take the machine to state B, so that if we receive a 1 and a 0 after that, we can still take the machine to the final state F and complete the pattern. So this is the design of the DFA, which will accept strings ending with either 0, 1, 1, 0 or 0, 1, 0 over the input alphabet 0, 1. Now let me ask you a question. We have seen the design of a NFA and a DFA for the same problem. Okay, the DFA in this case and the NFA in the previous example accepted the same language. So which one do you think was simpler? Was the DFA easier to design or the NFA easier to design? The answer is the NFA, which is easier to design, right? Then why are we studying DFAs? The actual reason is that when we want to design finite automata, actually our aim is to design a minimal DFA. That is because all real life machines that we can see are deterministic. We don't see non-deterministic behavior from real life machines. So all the machines that we design are deterministic finite automata in real life. And we of course want the deterministic finite automata to have minimum number of states. Hence we want to design a minimal DFA. That's the end goal. But designing a minimal DFA is not that easy for certain problems. So we basically start from a DFA and we minimize the DFA. We have already solved problems to see how we can minimize a DFA. But even designing DFAs are quite difficult for some problems. So we can start with an NFA, first design the NFA, then we can convert the NFA to DFA and the DFA to minimal DFA. So this part where we convert the NFA to DFA is not yet known to us. In the next class, we are going to look at some problems and discuss how we can convert NFAs to DFAs. Thank you.